Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. I hope you all are safe and happy there. In today's video, I'm going to tell you about the different courses you can choose here in Canada after your pharmacy. Before going into the courses, you must know about the different levels of education here. The first one is certificate courses. Second one is the diploma courses, which is again divided into postgraduate diploma and advanced diploma. Third category is the bachelor's, fourth is master's, and fifth one is the doctoral courses. Also, as a safe side, it's always better to choose a two-year course. If you are applying for a two-year course, the duration of the work permit will be 3 years. It will also clear your way to getting PR, considering your work experience in Canada for the past 12 months in 3 years. That meantime, if you are planning to work here as a pharmacist, try to attend the PBC evaluating examination. It will also boost your CRS score. In today's video, I have included only the diploma courses here. I will tell you about the different courses, its short description and the career opportunities after that course. And I will do more videos about the master's, doctoral and certificate courses. So let's get started. The first one is diploma or advanced diploma in biotechnology. Career in biotechnology holds many opportunities to make an impact in the industrial, government and the health sectors. After completing this course, you could work in life sciences, pharmaceuticals, industries, food sciences and government institutions, etc. The basic requirement for this course is you must have a graduate or degree in pharmacy or any health science field. Also, you have achieved overall 6.5 score in IELTS, and yeah, that is the main eligibility requirements for this course. I think almost all the courses I explained in this video having the same eligibility requirements, that is for IELTS 6.5 and holds a pharmacy degree. Okay, so. And the second course is the chemical technology. This chemical technology program will prepare you to work as a chemical technologist in the industrial, pharmaceutical and the government sectors, which is again a beautiful course if you are interested to work as a chemical technologist. The third course, that is healthcare administration, which is again a two-year diploma program. In this healthcare administration program, you will get more familiar to the Canadian healthcare system, and you can find job opportunities in various healthcare sectors like hospitals, clinics, etc. With graduation in the healthcare administration program, we will step into the designations like hospital manager, hospital financial officer, clinical administrator and human relations personnel, etc. And our fourth course, that is chemical laboratory analysis. This program focuses on chemical and environmental laboratory analysis, and becoming a graduate in this course, you could work as a analytical technician, biochemistry technician, biological lab technician, chemical analyst, pilot plant technician, QC technician, etc. And our fifth course, that is pharmaceutical and food science, chemical laboratory technology. It's a two-year advanced diploma program. And about the career options of this course could be food safety technologist, microbiologist, pharmaceutical technologist, quality assurance or quality control technologist, food product development technologist and analytical chemist. Sixth course is the food safety and quality assurance management. So this program mainly focused on the principles of food safety and the quality assurance management, and the employment may include in the positions as food safety and QA technicians, lab technicians, regulatory coordinators or industry consultants. Yeah, that's all about the diploma courses in Canada you can choose here after your pharmacy. Admission requirements for most of the colleges is IELTS 6.5 overall, and you should access your education via BES or ICAS. The pharmaceutical program admission requirements and the fee structures, everything will vary from province to province, and it highly depends upon the course you select. So that is why I not mentioned about any colleges or the fees in this video. If you want me to do a video about the courses in a specific province, please let me know in the comment section. If you can apply directly to the college, that's the way better than applying through an agency. Also, I have found that many colleges having tie up with certain agencies. So if you're planning to get admission through an agency, go to that specific agency only. It will clearly mention in almost all the college website. You will get all the immigration details from the government website. I will provide the link in the description box. And I hope you guys like this video. So see you next time. Take care, be safe, and bye bye.